Hello everybody, DarkSpineSonic3 here, coming to you with another episode of Dark Souls. In the last episode, we began our trek through the forest, trying to figure out what was going on. We fought another Black Knight, and we got destroyed by the Hydra. In this episode, we're going to be trying something a little bit different. We're going to fight the boss that's present in this area. Why? Oh, it's quite simple. He holds the key to, unlocking Havel the Rock's location so that we can get that ring that allows us to carry more stuff than ever before. And I want that. I need that. I've never needed something more in my life. Ooh, nice hit. Try it again. Nice try. Anyway, you gonna drop some? Oh, cool, you did. Blooming purple moss clump. Let's just check real quick and make sure that it does do what I think it does. Reduces poison and toxin, restores status. Okay, so yeah, that's the cure-all. Nice. There are a couple places we can go. We can go directly to the boss, which I think we're gonna do, or we can head down there. So I think we're gonna go to the boss, head down there, see what kind of trouble we can get into. The answer's lots. And then, from there, we're going to work our way down to the Hydra, get our souls back, and then get destroyed again. But after we get the Havel gear. Well, not the Havel gear, but the, Havel gear actually comes a lot later, but it's still pretty useful. But we're gonna have to get that ring. I need that ring. And thankfully, we're gonna be getting plenty of souls here. So, I should be able to upgrade my strength. It'll really help out in the fight that's coming up with the Hydra, because it seems like three hits with the Drake Sword takes off one of its heads, and we need to be able to take off all those heads in order to be successful. So, there's our butterfly friend just sitting there. And here's where we go to fight it. So let's give it a shot. First things first, though, I want to see if there's a better magic shield. Aside from that one, doesn't look like it. Not too keen on using it. Yeah, I'm not too keen on using it, but it looks like it's our best bet. Hope you guys enjoy the music. I actually really like it. Okay. So this thing has two different types of attacks. Three if you count its, Ooh, yeah. That's not gonna work out. Okay. So, the first attack... Okay, no, it's got three attacks. Alright. So, that first attack where it did the spread shot, that attack is very easily sidestepped and dodged. Basically, the key of this fight is to just keep on dodging. Realistically, I'm not doing much good for myself here. There we go, that's the one I was worried about. Anyway, any second now, she's gonna come down, and that's your moment to strike. She's basically dragging this on for a lot longer than it needs to be. Actually, let's go with the Grass Crest. We're going with Grass Crest simply because I like it, and it restores my stamina a lot better. Let's try the strong attack. Ooh, that actually did a lot of damage. And then, of course, an AoE attack that does a lot of damage because, you know, it's a boss. AoE stands for Area of Effect, I believe. If not, then I'm really clever and I thought that up on the spot. But it seems like we're not doing too bad here. Just keep on sidestepping. There's something I want to talk about. What was that? I do not remember that. I feel like that shouldn't have happened. But, you know. Oh well, I guess. There is something I want to talk about for those of you who like Dragon Ball Super or are fans of Dragon Ball in general. I just recently watched episode 54. Which centers around Goku going to meet the King of All. Oh, Jesus Christ. Twin Humanities. Oh no. Okay, I can use this moment here to set it to... Where is it? Humanity. Humanity heals you when you use it. Really helpful. Especially in this situation now that my Estus flask is gone. Come on. Fight me. About to be Meta Knight about this.
Fight me!
So this thing's hitting pretty hard, and I don't like it. Plenty of humanity to go around. I am incredibly scared. Come on! It's not that hard. Just lay down. Turn around and die. Ooh, we're running out of humanity. Yes! This is what I was looking for. Not today! I can't believe I actually kicked. But thankfully, we killed it. We got the soul of the Moonlight Butterfly. And some humanity. Which, let's save it. On our empty Estus flask.
Aw, man.
But anyway, when we come up these stairs here, we're gonna find something really strange. And I don't know if anyone's ever theorized anything regarding this, but check out this blacksmith. He looks familiar. But he's got the Watchtower Basement Key. And what else does he have? A Divine Ember. Homeward Bone. That's pretty neat. But he looks just like Andre of Astora. For some strange reason. Also, his tools like to do this when you break them. It's kind of weird. I'm no one to judge, but, you know. Stop. Are they gonna fall? Yes, they are. Oh, wow. Except for... What? Right. Anyway, he looks like Andre, and I wonder if anyone's theorized that Andre is related somehow to the god of smithing, because that's what the statue is supposed to represent, especially given that it is in possession of a divine ember, which is used to make holy weapons. You'd think that with the god of smithing looking identical to Andre of Astora, it would have some sort of connection to him being a descendant, similar to how... Gwyn and his children are revered as gods because of their power over fire and sunlight. But, you know, I have no clue. I'm just kind of here. Thankfully, we killed everything that we need to kill on our way over here. So we can just take this back road. Well, not back road, but the back streets. Alright! And then we just head back up and we go level up first off, because, oh my god, I'm scared. If I die here... Not there. But you notice that we got a Moonlight Butterfly soul. Those are used in two situations. The first situation is where you use it and it gives you a really hefty amount of souls, which is what we're going to be doing. But the other situation is if you want to create a weapon with that soul. You can't. You would be able to create a unique weapon that would allow you to use a weapon with the same effect as the attacks of the butterfly. But I don't really like it. But let's check out a little bit of backstory on the butterfly. Soul of the mystical Moonlight Butterfly, which flitters in the Darkroot Garden. Special beings have special souls. The butterfly soul is a creation of Seath the Scaleless, used to acquire a huge amount of souls or to create a unique weapon. Well, we're gonna use it. Too bad for those who wanted to see it. It's not even that many souls. Wow, that was a waste. I was excited for a second. But we've got enough for one, almost two levels, so we can just head back down and destroy one of those tree demons, and then we can level up another time. But strength is going up. And first things first, what I want to do is let's reverse the hollowing here. And then I'm going to use this opportunity to kindle the bonfire. We aren't really going to be coming back here very often, but during the times that we do, I want to be able to have extra uses of my Estus Flask, simply because we ran out at a very inopportune moment, and I feel like the forest on the other side of that door is a lot more difficult than what we saw out of the butterfly. The butterfly was tense, but it wasn't horribly difficult. It actually ended up using a different attack than what I was used to, though. It was actually kind of new. So, we just need to keep our eyes peeled for the first, first part. But other than that, we need to really just have our Estus Flask upgraded and our strength up. And thankfully, here we go. Let's level up. Strength one more time, because endurance for the moment is basically right where we need it to be, given that we're going to go fight Havel the Rock now and take his crap. And with this Grass Crest shield, which is what I use for the most part on my level 80 account, our stamina's refreshed a lot easier and a lot faster, so it just works out. It works out for me. Well, I hope it works out for you guys, because I'm the one playing the game. But yeah. Stop that. I don't like it. Stranger Dink! What are you going to do? Nothing. Bye. Anyway, we've got one humanity left, which we can use to kindle the bonfire down in Darkroot Basin, which is a really good idea, given that we're going to be spending a lot more time down there. Believe me. It's not going to be fun. But we got to do it. We got to do it. So, I'm thinking, first things first, we're going to upgrade the bonfire in the Darkroot Basin, which is where we are right now. Then, we're going to go fight Havel the Rock and take the ring that will allow us to carry more stuff, or at least to carry things easier. And then, we're going to go try and defeat the Hydra. Easier said than done. But we'll give it a shot. On the plus side, Black Knight's gone, so we don't have to worry about fighting him again. So let's just slide down the hill here and make our way over. All things considered, this run is going a lot smoother than I thought it would, and that's still kind of shocking considering I've died a pretty considerable amount of times. But here we are at the bonfire. Who's ready to see some lights? I'm not hollow. Anyway, the reason why we're going to fight Havel the Rock, and the reason why he's not going to be a very worthwhile adversary to us, or, you know, a teammate, is because he's already gone hollow, and there is no saving him. He has gone totally insane. He will attack anyone on sight, and there's nothing we or anyone else can do about it. It's kind of unfortunate, really, because Havel the Rock seems like a pretty chill dude. So I want to dive a little bit into the backstory of this game, and the reason why, drakes are attacking. So, and the reason why Seat the Scaleless is relevant. So Gwyn, the Lord of Sunlight, and the final boss of the game, is kind of a dick in that he doesn't like dragons and he also can't accept change. So he linked the first flame with himself, I believe, so that it would go on for a much longer amount of time than before. And the reason why that's bad is because here we are, everybody's hollow, everyone's focusing on Sun. Wow, he's just right there. No, that's not nice. Get out of here. Okay, he didn't like that. Oh yeah, you're gonna walk out here? No, you aren't. So we need to focus on Mr. The Rock here. He is a very, very hefty opponent. Look at that thing. But we can backstab him like usual. And then two-handed knock him out. And then backstab him again. Realistically, what we have to do is we just need to keep our shield up, target onto him, and then hold right. Because he's going to end up doing strong attacks like that. They have a huge wind-up time and a really long cooldown. So we don't really need to worry about too much. Just keep backstabbing him. That's all I can really say, because he's kind of a tool. Oh! Okay. But he's dead. And what do we get out of the deal? Havel's ring. Awesome. So now we can finally start wearing rings. So, let me show you what this ring does. This ring was named after Havel the Rock, Lord Gwyn's old battlefield compatriot. Havel's men wore the ring to express faith in their leader and to carry a heavier load. So what does it do? Our equipment load will increase from, I believe it was 63 to 94.5. Doug FM. I don't think that's the correct, I really don't know if that's the correct, number, but whatever. Who cares? So now we got the Elite Knight gear. We're still rolling moderately slowly, but at least we're not throwing ourselves onto the ground and refusing to get up. And we could actually wear the Elite Knight helm, but it's not really going to help us out too much here. So let's just compare armor real quick, see what's best for us. Elite Knight armor. Gauntlets, alright. And leggings, leggings, leggings. Well, looks like we made the right choice. And it doesn't seem like the regular Knight leggings are too far behind, but I still like these. I still like these because they do offer a little bit more protection. And weight, the weight difference isn't high enough for it to be a viable replacement. So, at this rate, we're doing great. We've got what we need. We used the Watchtower Basement Key. Now we're right back where we were when we fought the Taurus Demon. And this guy's dead. No problem. I really like this armor. It's kind of symbolic for me. And I really want to see if that twinkling Titanite lizard's still in here. Yes, he is. And he's dead, too. Ooh. Awesome. Works for me. Anyway. So we're doing it, guys. Now we just need to come back down to the first floor. Now let's make our way back down. Make our way downtown. Running fast, stairs just past, then we're Darkroot Basin bound. I think first thing we should do, though, actually, is head back to the bonfire. Because I don't really feel like traveling all that way, but we also have a lot of these large nameless souls. I think large nameless soldier souls, I believe they're called. Yes, and I want to use these because they offer 1,000 each. So, one more. Now let's go level up. I said, let's go level up. And Havel the Rock is never coming back. He's dead for good, and we killed him. Goodbye, GG, no re. GG easy. Is what I would say if it wouldn't be replaced with I'm insecure, but thanks for playing anyway. So, I wonder if anyone's heard about that. Well, actually, I'm pretty sure a lot of people have, but for any of my viewers, Overwatch like to, they change the censorship in some of the words in their chat, so if you write GG easy, it will say things like, I'm having insecurities, but thanks for playing with me anyway. And what else was there? I'm up past my bedtime, please don't tell mommy. I think that's pretty funny. And it's basically just unsportsmanlike, lingo. Oh no. Ouch. Alright, let's use some humanity here, because I don't think these guys drop anything, and if they do, it's not really worthwhile, but hey. Item discovery rates going up are still pretty nice for me. Pull out Arrestus Flask for the oncoming storm. That is a really strong upper punch, by the way. Hooray, he's dead too. And we really do need to take care of these extra crystal golems, simply because they will get in our way, especially while we're fighting the Hydra, which is what we're off to next. Ah. Been sitting in this chair for an hour. Okay, where's the other one? Thankfully, we can just get them in the way of these water torrents. Come on, buddy. Fight me. Ooh. That was a nice shot. Whoa. But you're dead. Hey, what'd he drop? Blue Titanite chunk. I had no idea they dropped anything. And that's what happens when you use humanity. Oh. Narrowly dodged that. Alright. So we're gonna need to make this quake grab our souls at least. So now we're going on to the big part of this fight. They roar, and then they come up to us, and then we fight them. I guess it takes more than four hits. Ouch. Stop that. Come here. Fight me again. They hit really hard, so you need to really be careful what you're doing here. Especially since if I go too far forward, I fall into the water and automatically die. Just be careful. You might actually be able to see the line. I'd say it's a good 4 or 5 steps further. Ugh. Look at that little bloody stump. Stumpy little head. Come on. Thankfully, I can tell when he's attacking. I wish I had the, rusted iron ring, though. That way I could walk in here easier. Because, oh my god. Water slows you down so much. But we're doing pretty okay right now, so let's keep going. And if we're close enough, then his water torrents will go over us, and then he'll lunge at us again. And we can do this. Another head down. Thankfully, unlike the other Hydra iterations, we don't need to worry about his heads coming back. That's another head down. How many are left? 1, 2, 3. Awesome. Okay, 2. We're hitting hard. Or hardly hitting. I like this. We're doing great. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? I'm gonna keep menacingly walking towards you. Okay, we hit him. We hit him. Almost there, guys. This is one of the more stressful battles for me starting out, because I had no idea what I was doing here. Thankfully, if you just keep your shield up and keep your distance, for the most part, everything goes smoothly. But you also need to stay close. You need to stay close at the same time. Okay, one head left. You're dead. You are dead, sir. But usually the head flies over there. So here comes the part where we need to be a little more forward thinking. He always goes a little bit further each time, I've noticed. So let's check it out. Where's he going? We missed that time. Thankfully, we still got a lot of leeway when it comes to, making our shot. I think if we stay in this area right here, then we have a better shot of hitting his head. And I guess I was wrong there, because we're still doing horribly. Damn it! If I pulled out that bow and arrow, this would be a lot easier for me, but at the same time, I need to try and not rely on that, because I don't know where his hits are going to... I don't know where these hits are going to land. Come on! That should have hit him. If hitboxes are crap for this for me, then it should be crap for him too. Almost there. Head's almost gone. Head's almost gone. Come on. Yeah, the head was not close enough for that one. We're doing alright. We're doing alright, though, because... No! Damn it! This game is stressful. No, I'm not going to equip the bow and arrow. We can do this with a sword. This also isn't the last time we're going to be fighting this beast, so... Be sure to remember what you learned here today, because there is another Hydra later on in the game, towards the end. Come back over here. Stop that! It's not nice. Strong attacks are not working out for me as well as I was hoping. Alright, screw it. Bow time. That's not what I wanted to do, but okay. And then he comes close. Thanks. Dick. Anyway... This is actually really stressful, because I'm trying to remember the buttons again. Well, it's doing damage. Oh! So close. I'm going to put this away now. This isn't working out anywhere near as well as I was hoping it would. So we're going back to the Drake Sword. I don't perform well under pressure. I know it's double-handed, strong attack, normal attack after I aim, but I can't possibly concentrate enough with this thing constantly attacking me in different angles. Alright, alright. You're dead. You're dead, Will. And we got a dragon scale, so we can upgrade this thing. And a dust crown ring. What's that do? Grants extra sorcery castings, but halves HP. No thank you. No thank you. So, now that the Hydra here is dead, there's something kind of special in this cave. But wait a second, you might be asking. There's nothing in this cave. And I'd say, cheekily, that's not a question. But if we quit the game, because it auto-saves, and then we start it back up again, and we go past Hilshigledig and Pookie, who both look equally horrifying. Hilshigledig looks like Sephiroth, but also like a crushed juice box. And Pookie looks like kind of blue, with like these big, big lips. It's weird. Frank's the only... Frank Daddy's the only normal-looking one here. Myself included. Ooh. So... I don't really think it takes, much... I don't really think I need to say too much, but... Here's a giant, golden golem. Okay, he's angry. So we just need to fight him. He likes doing that stomp, that smash attack where he sets out the crystals. Do not get caught in that. Oh man, we were so close. I got greedy and I wasn't paying attention to my health. So I'm gonna cut back to him and we're gonna take care of him. Alright? I'll see you guys there. And we're back, guys. Let's go for round two against the Golden Golem. Is there anything interesting that we can use? Well, I can punch him to death. That's probably not a good idea. Alright, come on. Hop at me. Walk this way. Ow! I'm going to walk back and pretend that didn't happen. As a matter of fact, I'll roll back. I am going to roll out. Thankfully, he stays the same disappointing speed. Ho ho! Aha, that's not good. Sorry for the interruption. But we're almost done. Ooh. Now we're actually getting some real combat in here. Too bad it didn't help. So he's dead. And she is saved. But who is she?
So, it is thou who rescued me.
No.
Most gracious, I am deeply obliged. I am Dusk of Ulysseal. I cometh from an age long before thine. I cannot stay here for long. So, before I disappear, allow me to ask one thing. My home, Ulysseal, is the home of ancient sorceries. My hope is to pass this profound knowledge to thee with thine approval. Would this be of assistance to thee?
Why, indeed it would. Probably not, but... don't really matter to me. You just get out of here. Anyway, there we go. We've saved her. I can't even remember her name. It wasn't really all that important. But now, whenever we go towards the trees where I found the knight armor, we can find her insignia engraved there, and we can summon her and buy spells and things from her. We can also learn a gesture where we do a proper bow like we're, you know, Japanese or British royalty. I think it's pretty nice. I've never actually used her sorceries. As a matter of fact, as soon as I summoned her, I killed her. Because I'm kind of a dick. But, oh well. So, I'm gonna fight these guys and then we'll be done. So much for that. I'll get my souls back another time. Sound good? Sounds good, because we have to go up the waterfall anyway. So as always, I'm Darkspine Sonic 3. If you liked what you saw in this episode, be sure to leave a like and a comment down below, and if you want to see more just like it, be sure to subscribe, because we've got plenty more to show. I'll see you all in the next episode. Thank you, and goodbye.